let's start now and do a few examples that have some numbers and get a little bit more complex. We have a car, it has a mass of 450 kilograms. It's rolling down a 20 degree incline, so this angle is 20 degrees. Find the total work done as the car moves 20 meters along the incline. So we're asking for the total work done. We might call that work net. We often do write it that way, so the net work or the total work. The net work is going to be the work done by each force all added up. So it's going to be work 1 plus work 2 plus work 3 and so on till we've added up the work done by each force. You might start by asking yourself, do you think the work is going to be positive or negative? Do you think the car slows up or slows down? And then we'll check in with our answer as we finish. So these problems do follow a structure. We'd like to find the work done. We know that work is force times displacement times the cosine of the angle between the force and the displacement. So we're going to have to figure out what's each force, and then we're going to have to plug each force into the equation done, into the equation for the work, and then we're going to have to take the sum. Our very first tip I'm going to put here in top, I'm going to write it in capital letters. I'm going to say be careful with the angle theta. We know that work is force times the displacement times the cosine of the angle theta. You've got an angle given in your text, 20 degrees. It's very tempting to pop that in wherever you see theta, but we've got to think critically about what theta means in our equation. Okay, let's get started. To find work, we need force. Let's start sorting out the forces. I look at my car, I ask what forces act on my car. I know the earth pulls down on it, that's the weight force. I know that the surface holds it up, that's the normal force. This is telling me I can neglect air resistance and friction, so I don't have any other forces, so I'm happy with just my normal force and my weight force. I'm going to put in my coordinate system. I'm going to take positive x to be parallel to the plane, and I'm going to take positive y to be perpendicular to the plane. Because this is a work problem, I think I'm just going to draw in my displacement at the top of my diagram, because I know the direction of my displacement is important. My displacement is down the hill. So to find my net work, I'm going to have to find the work done by the normal, the work done by the weight, and I'm going to have to add those up. So let's start with finding the work done by the normal force. My work done by my normal force is the magnitude of the force, so the magnitude of N, times the magnitude of the displacement, times the cosine of the angle between the normal force and the displacement. Now remember I said it's tempting to pop in 20 degrees because you have 20 degrees, but this angle theta is the angle between the normal force and the displacement. Let's make sure we know what this angle is. So to make sure we know the angle, let's draw the normal force. We know the normal force is perpendicular to the hill. There's N. Let's draw the displacement. The displacement is parallel to the hill because it's driving down the incline. And we know that our angle theta is the angle between these two vectors when they're drawn tail to tail. N is perpendicular, D is parallel. These two things are perpendicular. The angle theta for this equation is 90 degrees. So it's the magnitude of the normal force times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of the angle, which is 90 degrees, gives us 0. Remember, when a force and a displacement are perpendicular, the work done by that force is 0. Okay, there's my work done by the normal force. Let's also find the work done by the weight. Let's do this the same way. The work done by the weight is the magnitude of the weight times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of the angle between the weight force and the displacement vector. Again, it's tempting to pop in 20 degrees, but let's make sure we know what we're doing here. The weight vector points straight down towards the center of the Earth. There's the weight vector. Our displacement is down the hill, so perpendicular to the incline. If we wish, we can draw that as a triangle. So our weight is straight down here. Our displacement is down the incline like this. So we can draw it here. This is the angle of 20 degrees that we're given. The weight is straight down, the ground is horizontal. This is 90 degrees. We know that all of the angles in a triangle have to sum up to be 180 degrees. So this is our angle theta that we want. We draw displacement arm weight tail to tail. Theta is the angle between those two things. We know that 180 degrees equals theta plus 90 plus 20. That means theta is equal to 70 degrees. So if we want to find the work done by the weight, we put in the magnitude of the weight, that's m times g, times the magnitude of the displacement, times the cosine of the angle between them, that's 70 degrees. M is the mass of the car, 450 kilograms. G is the magnitude of the acceleration due to gravity, 9.81 meters per second squared. Remember, that's always positive. D is the magnitude of the displacement, that's 20 meters. Then we're multiplying by cosine 70 degrees. All that through the calculator, and we get 3.02 times 10 to the 4 joules. So we found the work done by each force. Now let's find the total work done. The total work done in this problem is the work done by the normal force plus the work done by the weight equals 0 plus the work done by the weight equals 3.02 times 10 to the 4 joules. At the beginning of the problem, we said we would think about, does the car speed up or slow down? Did that mean work was positive or negative? The work is positive, it means the car speeds up. And yeah, that's what we expect for a car rolling down a hill without friction. Okay, so there's one problem done. We found the net work if there was only two forces. Let's step it up a notch. Let's get more than two forces. So now some of the things we said in the previous problem we've written down here. We've given ourselves a little bit more structure now that the problem is a little bit longer. So what if there's more than one force? The net work done is the sum of each individual work. So work net is work 1 plus work 2 plus work 3 plus so on. So we find the work done by each force and we add them up to get the total work done. In this example, we've got a 25 kilogram box. We're pushing it across a rough floor. That tells us there's going to be friction. We're pushing it with 100 newton force. That's exerted at an angle of 20 degrees. Find the work done by each force and let's find the total work. Before, as we went through, we talked out our process. Here I've got it summarized in a little box in case you'd like to have a box of steps close by. So let's do a quick sketch of the problem. So here's our floor. Here's our box. Let's put the forces on the box. So we know that the earth pulls down on it. That's the weight vector. There's our W. We know that the surface holds it up. That's the normal force. We know that we're pushing it forward. That's that applied force. So there's F. That angle is going to be 20 degrees. And we know it's being slowed down by friction. It is moving, so it's going to be a kinetic friction. So there are all of our forces. Let's put our displacement on there because the displacement is important. It's moving to the right because this force is responsible for moving it. And let's put in our coordinate system. We'll take positive x to the right and positive y to be up. So now if we want to find the net work done, we have to find the work done by each of these four forces, then we have to add them up. So let's get started. Let's find the work done by the normal force first. So let's start with the normal force. So we'll go through them force by force. We'll find the work done by each force. So by the normal force. The work done by the normal force is equal to the magnitude of the normal force times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of the angle between the force and the displacement. So our normal force points up. Our displacement is to the right. We draw those vectors tail to tail. Normal is up, displacement is right. The angle between those two things is 90 degrees. So we've got the magnitude of the normal force times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of 90 degrees equals zero. Forces that are perpendicular to the displacement don't do any work. Okay, let's do weight next. You probably have a guess what the work done by the weight is going to be. The work done by the weight is the magnitude of the weight times the displacement times the cosine of the angle between the work, between the weight and the displacement. Again, I'll point out you have to be super careful with your angle. You've got 20 degrees in the text, so it's tempting to pop in 20, but we always have to ask, what is this angle? And we have to make sure we know it. Our weight vector points straight down. Our displacement vector is to the right. Down and right are perpendicular, so in this one, that angle is 90 degrees again. So we've got the magnitude of the weight, which is m times g, times the magnitude of the displacement, 10 meters, times the cosine of 90 degrees, equals zero. Again, forces that are perpendicular to the displacement don't do any work. So that's normal and weight done. We've got two more forces. We've got the pushing force and the friction force. I think I'm going to do the pushing force next, and we'll save the friction force for last. Now this page is getting a little bit full. Let's get another sheet of paper. Now hopefully we can see the diagram and the fresh paper. So the work done by the pushing force is equal to the magnitude of the pushing force times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of the angle between the pushing force and the displacement. Let's draw the vector and the displacement again. Our pushing force is 20 degrees below the horizontal. Our displacement is horizontally to the right. This angle is 20 degrees, is the given angle. So our work done is the magnitude of the pushing force, that was 100 newtons, times the magnitude of the displacement, 10 meters, times the cosine of the angle between them, which is 20 degrees. Put that through the calculator, we get 940 joules. Okay, one more force to go, and this one is going to be the hardest one. Now we have to find the work done by the friction force. So let's get started with our equation, and we'll see what we have to do as we go along. So the work done by the friction force is the magnitude of the friction force times the magnitude of the displacement times the cosine of the angle between them. Let's deal with the angle first. So my friction force is to the left. There is my kinetic friction. My displacement is to the right. There is my displacement. Those two things are exactly opposite. That means the angle between them is 180 degrees. Equals Fk, the magnitude of the friction force, times the magnitude of the displacement, times cosine 180 degrees. Okay, so cos 180 is easy, d is easy, that's 10 meters. Fk, not quite so easy. So we have to figure out what is our kinetic friction. So we have to go back to the tools we learned in chapters 5 and 6. We know that kinetic friction is the coefficient of friction times the normal force. That means we're going to have to figure out the normal force. So we're going back to all of our tools from chapters 5 and 6. So let's recap that really quickly. If you were doing this on a test, you wouldn't have to redo all these steps. I think I am going to redo them just for a little bit of practice. So in our free body diagram, we had the normal force up, we had the weight down, we had our pushing force is down and right. That has two components. The x component is to the right, the y component is down. So there's our F, there's Fx, there's Fy. There's 20 degrees, and our friction force is to the left. So this is a free body diagram like we might have drawn in chapters 5 or 6. Now that we've got our free body diagram, our next thing would be to sort our forces into components. We've got the normal force, the pushing force, the weight force, the friction force, trying to find the x and y components. Normal force is not left or right, so it's 0 in the x, positive in the y. The pushing force is to the right in the x, so it's positive. The x component is adjacent to the angle, so we have to use F times cosine, 20 degrees. Our y component points down, so it's negative in the y. The y component is opposite the angle, so we have to use sine, 20 degrees. Our weight force is not left or right, it's all negative in the y direction, so that's minus mg. Our friction force is not up or down, so that's 0 in the y direction. It's negative in the x direction because it's left, and here we'll remember that it's minus mu k times the normal force. So if I want to find the magnitude of my friction force, I need to find the magnitude of my normal force. So let's do that. To find the magnitude of my normal force, I'm going to apply Newton's second law in the y direction. Sum of the forces in the y is mass times acceleration in the y, n minus f sine 20 minus mg equals m times 0 equals 0, n equals f sine 20 plus mg equals our pushing force is 100 newtons times sine 20 degrees plus m times g, m is 25 kilograms times 9.81 meters per second squared. So the magnitude of our normal force is 279 newtons. Now that we know the magnitude of the normal force, we can find the magnitude of the friction force. So our friction force is going to be mu k times n. Let's come back to our equation for our work done by the friction force. Let's see. I think it was this pen. So Fk equals mu k times n. Magnitude of the friction force is the coefficient times the magnitude of the normal force, 0.200 times 279 newtons gives us 55.9 newtons. Now we can find the work done by the friction force. Work done by friction is the magnitude of the friction times the magnitude of the displacement times cosine 180 degrees equals 55.9. Remember, this is magnitude of friction, that's why it's positive. The displacement, the distance traveled, was 10 meters times cosine 180 degrees. You might remember that that's equal to negative 1. Gives us minus 559 joules. Okay, so we found the work done by each individual force. The work done by weight and normal was 0. Work done by the pushing force was 940. For some strange reason, I put a degrees symbol there. Let's just cross that out. The work done by the friction force was negative 559. This one's positive because the pushing force tends to speed it up. This one's negative because the friction force tends to slow it down. Our total work done then is going to be the sum of each of those works. Work done by normal plus work done by weight plus work done by pushing force plus work done by friction equals 0 plus 0 plus 940 minus 559, so the negative comes from right there, gives us positive 381 joules. So overall, the box does speed up because the net work is positive.